Now let us on the constraints. First of all, in any question which is based upon linear programming, you must remember that the exam questions will pertain to number of units. How many units you have to produce for schedule price, maximum profit, minimum cost, and the production of units cannot obviously be negative. So even if it is not stated in your question, you will have two non-negativity constraints. By non-negativity constraints, we mean that a company cannot produce negative pool queues. It can either produce zero pool queues, that is, it doesn't produce anything of pool queues, or it can make one, two, three, four, and so on of pool queues. However, it cannot produce negative one, negative two, negative three pool queues. Likewise, snooker queues cannot be negative. So these two inequalities, which define that the production cannot be negative, are also known as non-negativity constraints. After identifying these two, let us move on to the third paragraph, this paragraph, which has the easier constraints. It says HHC sells the queues to a large market. Demand for the queues is strong, and in any period, 15,000 up to 15,000 pool queues and 12,000 snooker queues could be sold. So it means that you cannot sell more than 15,000 pool queues. However, you can sell lesser than 15,000 pool queues if you want. Likewise, you cannot sell more than 12,000 pool queues. However, yes, if you want, you can sell less than 12,000 pool queues if you want. After that, we know that the ash amount was restricted or limited. As stated in paragraph number 1, it said that the supply of ash is restricted to 5,400 kilograms per period. And we know that we use 0.27 kgs of ash for pool cues and 0.27 kgs of ash for snooker cues. Therefore, the inequality for ash will be 0.27 P plus 0.27 S is less than or is equals to 5,400 kgs. We were also provided with the limit on number of hours. We were told that the labor hours limited is 12,000, and we were also provided with individual amount of hours required for the production of pool and snooker cues. Therefore, the labor equation or craftsman equation will be 0.5 P plus 0.75 S, which should be less than or is equals to 12,000. So we have identified all the constraint. Constraint number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We have also identified our objective function, and now we should be ready to draw our graph. Now, the thing to note is that here we have to actually draw the graph using the graph paper, because there are so many constraints, and if we sketch the graph, it will be really inaccurate. So you have to actually draw the graph. Do follow the instructions of your question. You are provided with a graph paper at the end of the answer sheet, and you are supposed to draw it. Draw means draw. You cannot sketch it. However, in solving this question in a video, I will just sketch it, but you all are required to practice drawing a graph. Now, if you have to draw the graph, we know that if we plot P on our y-axis and S on our x-axis, the first constraint said that P should be greater than or is equals to 0. This means that the values of P must be on the right-hand side of this line. The second inequality said S is greater than or is equals to 0. Sorry, for S is greater than or equals to 0, the value should be on the right-hand side of this y-axis. for p is greater than or is equals to 0, the value should be above here. Then we are provided with p should be less than or is equals to 15,000. P cannot be more than 15,000, it should be less than that. Let's say this is 15,000 and therefore p should be below this line. We are also said that s will be less than or is equals to 12,000. Let's say s is 12,000 over here, and therefore the production should be s should be less than or is equals to 12,000. So we have four conditions already over here: less than this, greater than this, and greater than this. For 5 and 6, we will have to draw first of all the straight lines. Equation number 5 and 6. 5 is 0.27p plus 0.27s is less than or is equals to 5400. The two points to plot the graph, as discussed in previous videos, should be 0, 5400 divided by 0.27 will be 20,000. And the second point will be 20,000 divided, 0. I haven't discussed how did I calculate this. If you have issues with it, you may refer to my previous videos in which I explained how do we calculate the two points. I wanted to save time over here, and therefore I directly calculated the values. Therefore this line will be somewhere from 20 to 20,000. Let's say this is 20 and the other 20 is somewhere over here. Well, since I'm just sketching the graph in the video, you are supposed to draw it very very accurately, and it will be something like this. Then we have point number 6 is 0.5p plus 0.75s is equals to 12,000. So 12,000 divided by 0.5 is 24,000. First of our point can be 24,000, 0. Our second point, if p is 0, will be 12,000 divided by 0.75, which is 16,000. So our second point will be 0, 16,000. And if I draw it on our graph, it will be starting from somewhere like here, 24,000, and it will go downwards and meet the 1600 or 60 sorry 16,000 mark somewhere over here. So it will go down like this. Since I have the drawn graph, I know that there is a intersection of after this line, but you are supposed to draw the graph accurately and you will get the points. It will move over here and then it will touch the 16th. So the feasible region is the region which satisfies all inequalities, and therefore our feasible region will be this region, because in this region all the conditions are met at the same time. This should be our feasible region. So part B said you should use a linear programming graph, identify the feasible region. We have identified the feasible region and the optimal point. Now we have to calculate the optimal point. For optimal point and further calculations, I will solve the further questions, further part of this question in my next video, or part 3 of the series of video for the question. Here I have just identified what a feasible region is. Our feasible region is the region which satisfies all inequalities, and it should be this region which satisfies all inequalities. And by that I mean that if you pick any point in this feasible region, it will meet all inequality conditions which we have plotted or listed above. Thank you for this video.